Anyway, pwede man ninyo ma-unmute ang inyong self if you want to speak. The dreadful state of the lukewarm soul. So this is taken from the writing of Saint John Marie Vianney. All the evils of the world are due to lukewarm Catholics. So dako giday kadaot ning lukewarm Catholics. All the evils of the world, imagine, are due to lukewarm Catholics, Pope Saint Pius V. So you may be thinking to yourself, I go to Mass each week, I pray the rosary often, and I try to follow the teachings of the church, and then I'm good. No? So dili automatically nga because you do these things, you are good, no? Avoiding lukewarmness is not a matter of marking a spiritual checklist. So, manguta na ta, lukewarm ba ko? So, nabay checklist para mahibawaan nato kung lukewarm ba ta? So, wala siya checklist actually. It's about our relationship with the Lord and how we respond. Unsa ganay respond sa Bisaya, it's kung unsa ta mitubag, no, sa hagit sa atong Ginoo sa iyang tawag kadato, no, sa iyang kanunay pagtawag kanato sa adlaw-adlaw. Catechism 2094, lukewarmness daw is the hesitation, ang pagduha-duha or sa kwan pa nga istorya, murag walay gana, no, nga pagtubag sa tawag sa atong Ginoo. It's the refusal to give oneself over to the prompting of charity. So, what is charity? The love of God towards us and our love toward God. No? So, charity, we are called to charity. So, if we fail to respond to that, or our hesitation, our half-hearted response to that, we are already called lukewarm. So how do we understand this? So we will understand this by looking from the standpoint of God on how He created us. Paano ta niya gibuhat? So He created us to be with Him. That is the design of God. No? So to be with Him in perfect unity and to reach perfect charity. No? So, because charity unites us with God. Again, gihimo ta sa Ginoo para ma-reach nato ang atong perfect unity, ang perfect charity. So, mo na atong paningkamutan nga i-reach, no? Kaya ang charity, maghiusa ka nato sa Dios. We must think often and intensely about heaven. So what is charity? Charity is we love God above all things and we love our fellow man because of the love of God, for the love of God. No? So i-correct na to ang notion nga sayop nga definition nga charity is love, to love God, and then number two, to love our fellow man. That is wrong. It has nanay sumpay dapat to love our fellow man because of the love of God. Dili siya pwede love our fellow man lang. Dapat gilove nimo ang imong fellow man because of the love of God. Okay. So in order not to be lukewarm, we must think often and intensely about heaven. No? So atong huna-hunaon sayop ang spelling a heaven. About heaven. Mao na ato huna-huna ang kanunay nga gihimo ta sa Ginoo para sa langit. So we should always think about heaven, about our future home, no? Dili lang kay often, intensely. Nice saying nga ingon sila, absence can make the heart grow fonder. Kadungog na mo ana? I'm sure kadungog na mo ana, no? Absence can make the heart grow fonder, bali Moingon sila over familiarity breeds contempt. So sometimes dapat kung di mo magkita, murag mingawon ka, no? Absence can make one of them heart grow fonder. It is true, no? If even in their absence, we continue to think about them. We desire their presence to communicate if possible. So tinuod ni nga saying, kining absence can make the heart grow fonder, kung wala sila sa imuhang presence, you still think about them. You still desire to be with them, or sometimes if you continue to communicate. But pure absence won't make the heart grow fonder. Di ba? Kaya nandun pa mo sa inyong mga classmate sa high school, na are you being fonder with your classmate? Dili na, di ba? Nalimot naman mo. Because you don't think about them. No? So, absence actually does nothing except to make us forget. So if you don't think about someone, if you don't think about God, if you don't communicate, if you don't desire to be with God, malimtan gini mo siya, no? That is the result of absence, of the absence of presence. So some people, a lot of people actually, they think about the things of this life. They think about earthly things. Majority of their thoughts is the things of this life, earthly things, invest in those things. And then they think to themselves, well, when I have spent all my energy, when I built up as much as I could, when I acquired all the treasures I could on earth, and then, well, after, then there will be a better place. Mo na mindset sa kadaghana, no? They always think of this world only. They invest on this world only. And then, kung ma-retire na sila, tiguan na sila, contento na silang buhay, after that, naana po'y naghulat nila nga better place, which is heaven. Mo na mindset sa uban. Well, that would be a very dangerous assumption. Ingon si Father. That would be a very dangerous assumption. Our Lord tells us that we are pilgrims, actually. Eh, ang pilgrims is a traveler nga walay permanente nga balay. So, and we should keep our bags light. And we should not be attached to the things of this world. No? Because we are pilgrims, actually. Investing all our energies, physical, emotional, spiritual, on things of this world. So, rather, we should constantly have our minds lifted up to our one true home, heaven. So, God is always calling us to love Him, to be with Him in heaven. That's our purpose where He created us. So, we should always think about heaven and Him. No? If we do not, then inevitably, we will become more and more attached to this world and in danger of losing the next. So let us ask ourselves, what thoughts occupy our mind most of the day? No? So God, who is love itself and the fire of love, tries to draw us and set us on fire for love of Him. Every day, ginatawag ta niya. Marag magnet bitaw, he attracts us. He is calling us. So, when we have those divine promptings, and we get those promptings, no? Marag, kabalo mo say promptings, marag calling, sa imuha, no? Marag feeling ni mo, tawag ka. But you fail to respond to that, then that is what we call lukewarmness. It's just like si God na asa imabaw sa bukid, nanawag ka na to, hey, come here, be with me, no? And then gusto po ta mo muuban kay God dito sa ibabaw sa bukid, no? But yet we see the mountain is pretty high, and going up there is going to be a rough trip, and so we hear God calling, This prompting of love calling me to go higher to reach God, but I don't feel like taking this journey. I don't feel like paying the price, because if you go the mountain, liso, di ba? You have to pay the price. So that is neglecting the charitable promptings of God. We neglect them because we get lazy. Daghang sacrifice, we have to take up our crosses, no? It's so difficult to pray, especially meditation, no? Take time to prayer. We don't really want to pay the price that love demands. So that is lukewarmness. The words of Saint John Marie Vianney. So in speaking to you today, my dear brethren, of the dreadful state of the lukewarm soul, my purpose is not to paint for you a terrifying, a despairing picture, no? So ato sa ning laktawan ning kwan. Dili ang tamukan. Okay. It's about mortal sin. So I think, brethren, that you would like to know what is the state of the lukewarm soul. So we will analyze if we have this. Well, a lukewarm soul is not yet quite dead in the eyes of God. Dili pa siya patay, no? Buhi pa. So naa pa siya sanctifying grace. Because sometimes, ako guilty ko ani nga, there were a period of my life nga when I learned the catechism and then I already stopped sinning and then I said, I'm happy, I don't have mortal sin, so this is it. And then, mo relax na ka because wala naman ko yung mortal sin. And then I become legalistic because this is it. I die in the state of grace, safe na ko. Pero sayop di ay. Because I fail to respond to the promptings of God to become higher and higher and higher in the mountain. So nakontento lang ko nga wala ko'y mortal sin. I just become legalistic. I fail to respond to the call of God to have a perfect charity. No? So a lukewarm soul is not yet quite dead in the eyes of God because the faith, hope, and charity of the spiritual life are not extinct. Naa pa sa iya, ha? No? But a lukewarm soul, nothing touches this soul. So I've experienced this. No, it hears the word of God. Yes. Minaw siya sa pulong sa Ginoo. That is true. But often it bores it. The possessor hears it with difficulty. It's more or less by habit na lang. Someone who thinks that he knows enough about it and does enough of what he should. So, kabalo na ko ana, and then nahimo na nako na unsay kinahanglan. Any prayer which are a bit long are distasteful to him. So, he is describing a person who has a lukewarm soul. This soul is so full of whatever it has just been doing or what is going to do next. So when he prays, ang iyang mind is full of whatever he has been doing or what is going to do next. And its boredom is so great that this poor unfortunate thing is almost in agony. It is still alive. As I've said, na pa siya sanctifying grace, but it is not capable of doing anything to gain heaven. Still alive, pero gahingalo na. No? This soul has been filled with good intentions. Gusto ko magbuhat ng ani for the poor, for the ministry, for the mission, but without doing anything at all to correct its habits. So daghan siyang habits, ng mga bad habits, nga naga hinder niya to grow to become a great saint. but he's not doing anything at all to correct its habits. It would not, however, wish to renounce eternal blessings. Dili siya ganahan nga mawala ang mga eternal blessing. Pero di po siya uyon mo biya ning kalibutan. Di po niya mabiya-biyaan ng worldly happiness and this world. Yet it does not wish either to leave the world or go to heaven. So, if it can just manage to pass its time without crosses or difficulties, it would never ask to leave this world at all. So, kung ang iyang kinabuhi kuno smooth lang gyud, walay mga pag-antos o walay mga problema, kumahimo pa lang, di na siya mabiya ng kalibutan. No? He wants a life without crosses. He will say that life is long and pretty miserable. Consulte siya ni Ana, just because only when everything is not going according to his desire, no? So mureklamo siya nga gusto na ko mubiya kapoy na ko ning kalibuhi because life is miserable only because ang mga sitwasyon wala ni uyon sa iya, no? If God sends it any crosses or suffering, like problems, sufferings, mga people nga mga naga-challenge sa iyahang patience, no? In order to force such a soul to detach itself from temporal things. So we can learn here, no? If God allows suffering to happen in our lives, the purpose is so that we can detach ourselves from temporal things. Mao na siya. Para dili kita bitaw masyado ka at ma-at home, that's why ang problems will happen to our lives. It is fret, and then if that happens, this lukewarm soul is fretful, grieving, abandons itself to grumbles, complaints, and often even to a kind of despair. And this person would say, what have I done to deserve all these trials? There are many other more blameworthy than me, no? Who have not submit to such trials. Bitaw, di ba? Ano ako pa man? Nadaghan pa man mas deserving at tagaan aning ang mga problema nga ako kuan man ko, mas layo ra akong kinabuhi sa iyaha. Mas buutan ra pa ko, no? In prosperous times, the lukewarm soul does not go so far as to forget God, but neither does it forget itself. So kung walay problema, nindot smooth sailing ang iyang kinabuhi, di man po niya malimtan si ang Ginoo, pasalamat mo po siya, pero di po niya malimtan ang iyang kagalingon. He always think of himself. It knows very well how to boast about all the means it has employed to achieve its prosperity. It is quite convinced that many others would not have achieved the same success. It loves to repeat that and to hear it repeated, and every time it hears it, it is with fresh pleasure. Say pasabot ato. So, he has a boastful heart, no? I'm also guilty of this, no? Sometimes, sa istorya sa mga amigo, sa mga kaila, you are so proud that na-reach ni mo ning level of success, no? And then, mo yung kag, wow, I am clever, no? Na successful ko tungod sa akong abilidad. O dili, kada gamay ra nga mga tao ang nakaabot ni ining success tungod sa akong pamaagi, no? And then ganahan ka maminaw, balik-balikon nga topic imong istorya sa imong mga friends. And then you, every time it is repeated, you hear it with pleasure. And then a lukewarm person assumes a gracious air when associating with those who flatter him. Mas ganahan siya to be with those person nga who always affirm him, flatter him, praise him. Pero sa mga tao nga wala kaya naghahatag kaniya og bili, wala kaya gahatag sa iya og much honor, much attention, no? Not been grateful for his kindness, he maintains an air of frigid indifference. Di kaya niya balihon itong mga tao nga wala kaya naghahatag ka niya o bili o wala kaya nagpahinungod kayo sa iya o the much honor that he deserves. So iya ang imurag i-cold treatment, no? A frigid indifference. And he wants to indicate to them that they are ungrateful creatures who do not deserve to receive the good which he has done to them. So a lukewarm person is like a turtle nga ang iyahang spiritual growth is hinay kayo, dragging itself along the ground. And one can see it getting from place to place with great difficulty. So the love of God, which it feels deep down itself, is like a tiny spark. So instead of a burning flame, the love of God, sa iyaha, it has become already a tiny spark. Hidden pagyod sa mga abo. No? Kamatsinon. It has nothing left but a love without tenderness. Love without action. Love without energy. Which sustains it with difficulty in all that is essential for salvation. So, ang love which is needed for salvation, it has to have tenderness, action, and energy. Gusto niya mo act, it would like to act, but its will has become so softened and it lacks either the force or the courage to accomplish its wishes. Murag, kuan mi to? Tunga-tunga sa gusto mo mata o gusto matulog, twilight. It is true that a Christian who lives in timidity still regularly in appearance at least fulfills his duty. So a lukewarm soul still fulfills his duties in appearance. He will indeed get down on his knees every morning to say his prayers. Nagapray pagyapon siya every morning, even get down to his knees or her knees. He will go to the sacraments every year at Easter and even several times during the course of the 12 months. But in all of this, there will be such a distaste. Walay lami. Much slackness, so much indifference, so little preparation. So, diri nato makita nga, to receive the sacraments, to go to the sacraments, especially the mass, kinanglan dig preparation, which is nalimta na natin sa kadaghanan, no? We just go there without preparation. So little change in his way of life that is easy to see that he is only fulfilling his duties from habit and routine. So kung mangumpisal siya, dili man siya sacrilegious, sakto man, but they are type of confession and communion which bear no fruit, which far from making him more perfect, instead of making him more perfect slowly day by day, it only makes him more unworthy because he does not put his mind to it. No? Pati ang iyang confession. In the morning, it is not God who occupies his thoughts, nor the salvation of his poor soul. He is quiet, taken up with thoughts of work. So instead of God occupies his mind, it's the work. His mind is so wrapped up in the things of earth that the thought of God has no place in it. He is thinking about what he is going to do to be doing during the day. So when he prays, instead of thinking of God, talking to God, saying his prayers, he is thinking of what he is going to do during the day. where he will be sending his children, asa niya dalang yung mga anak, ang iyang mga empleyado, and unsaon niya para mapadali niya ang trabaho. And to say his prayers, he gets down on his knees, undoubtedly, but he does not know what he wants to ask God. Wagay siya kabaloon sa iya pa ngayon kay God. Nor what he needs, nor even before whom he is kneeling. So, yeah. Me, myself, I'm guilty sometimes when you pray, you're so distracted. Daghan kag sa mga imong mind. Sometimes you just say your prayers, nahuman imong prayer, then wala, di ka conscious kung kasi imong, nasa imong atubang, which is God. Sometimes na routine na, no? So that's why I have to repeat my prayer again. So and I have to understand every word that comes out of my mouth because it is God you are kneeling in front of. His careless demeanor shows this very clearly. So makita sa iyang careless demeanor. Sa iyang careless nga panggawi. So you can see that this lukewarm soul has no difficulty, why problema niya in the slightest in talking during the course of his prayers. Pray siya, din makipagtabi pa, or kung sa iyang cellphone. Okay, wa pa may cellphone sa una, so din niya ni mahimo example. For no reason at all, he will abandon them, his prayer. Partly, at least, thinking that he will finish them in another moment. Biyaan niya, kay na siya nahuna-hunaan, iyang prayer. Down, interrupt niya. He does all that, but often without thinking of the one who is addressed. It's God. He will not even stop working. If the possessor of the lukewarm soul is a man, he will turn his cup or his hat around in his hands or if to see whether it is good or bad, as though he has some idea of selling it. So, example niya, ang tao ko no, example na ikalo, na siya ikalo, mo man yung example sa una pero karon ang example lang sila for sure cellphone or ano ba habang ga pray siya iya pang kuha niya ang kalo tanaw niya ang kalo kung nindot ba o gahuna-huna siya ibaligya ba niya ang dili so iyan ang mga distractions so makita sa iyang demeanor unsa siya kaseryoso dili seryoso sa iyang prayer no? And if you like such distractions during prayer are not exactly deliberate wala man kuno gituyo during prayer. Pero, dili siya ganahan aning mga distractions, pero wapod siya gibuhat para mawala niya mga distractions. Tungod kay nakita niya na para mawala niya distractions, kinahanglangid siya mo mangusog, mo concentrate, o maningkamot effort yun. Pero nakita niya nga grabe kita ang effort nga gipangayoan eh, munang okay ra niya moabot ni from time to time. No? So, ikumpara sa mga saints, they do violence to themselves. No? Like Saint John of the Cross, he threw himself to the thorn bushes para ang mga lustful thoughts mawala. So, those are extremes. No? You need to have the grace to have them. Pero, you really have to try your best to remove those distractions. So, that's why one of my concrete actions when I go to the prayer room to pray in the morning, ang akong pamagi is I leave my cell phone on the room. Hindi na ako ibilin. Hindi na ako dalon. Basig, madistract ko. Ano, isa po sa akong pamagi, and then, pag matani mo sa buntag, grabe katulogon lang, may good, kaya itulog kaya ako. Na yung mga tao nga, dili bitaw nila problema ang pagmata sa buntag. Ako, problema gina ako kay hingatulgon kay ko. Makasandig lang kong puste, makatulog na ako. Yan ako kay hingatulgon, no? So, pagmata sa buntag, para makamata ko pray, 5 o'clock, I'll just think of, this will be my penance. Ha? Bisa kung sa ako tulogon, mo matalang ko lang ko, I will offer this as a penance. I will offer this for the conversion of sinners. So, to pray. Muna akong pamaagi. So, the lukewarm Christian may not perhaps work on Sunday. Di po siya mo trabaho sa Sunday. Kay iya mag-observe bang siya, no? But doing some sewing, arranging something in the house, driving sheep to the fields during the times for masses. Mapunato na ginabuhat, no? On the pretext that there is not enough food to give them, all these things will be done without the slightest scruple. Such people will prefer to allow the souls of their souls and the souls of their employees to perish. I'm sure wa po siguro nato ning ibuhat because we really take time to go to mass. This, he is describing mo prefer pa siyang mo tigway sa mga baka kumpara sa musimba, no? The confession of such a person are merely repetitions of the old ones. No? So, but igo batane. Repetition lang sa mga old ones, more na routine na, no? Which nga mahapita nga wala na tayo naduga nga sa daan natong i-confess. We are already happy if there will be nothing to add to them. 20 years ago, he was accusing himself of the same things. He confesses today, and if he goes to confession for the next 20 years, he will say the same things. Meaning, it just reflect nga wala gid siya kaya naga preparation, na examination of conscience. A lukewarm soul will not, if you like, commit big sins. Wala siya mga mortal sins. Wala siya nagakommit og mga big sins. But slander or backbiting, a lie, feeling of hatred, feeling of dislike, jealousy, a slight touch of deceit, or double dealing, this count for nothing with it. So, wala siya mga big mortal sins, pero okay lang niya ning mga slander, backbite, feeling hatred, dislike, jealousy, deceit, no? On that day, when she wants to receive her God, say meaning ane, when she wants to receive her God, communion. On the day of communion, like Sunday, she spends part of the morning thinking of temporal matters. So, dapat din, before you receive Holy Communion on Sunday, bisang atong mind di ay, nag-prepare na di ay dapat, no? Nag-prepare na to receive Holy Communion. So, a lukewarm soul spends part of the morning thinking of earthly things. If it is a man, he will be thinking about his deals and his sales. If it is a married woman, she will be thinking about her household, her children. And if it is a young girl, her thoughts will be on her clothes. So the lukewarm soul shuts up in an obscure and ugly kind of prison. So, murag ibutang nato si God sa atong heart na ay gamay nga prisuhan, murag ato na siyang ibutang diha. We are putting God in a box. He is not the God of our life, but he is just part na natay religion, no? So our lukewarm soul shuts God up in an obscure and ugly kind of prison. Its possessor does not crucify him, but God can find little joy or consolation in his heart. So God is in the heart of that person. Pero kung mutanaw si God within his heart, God cannot find joy and consolation. So ang iyang mga actuation, ang iyang demeanor, ang iyang disposition, all proclaim that his soul is struggling for the breath of life. Naghihingalo. Napai-sanctifying grace, di papatay, pero naghihingalo. After having received Holy Communion, this person will hardly give another thought to God in the days to follow. His manner of life tells us that he did not know the greatness of the happiness which he had been. So, pag umanig communion, go back na to the worldly thoughts, and then, wala niya na-realize nga he just experienced the great happiness his soul received. No? Iyan ang naangkon unta. A lukewarm Christian thinks very little upon the state of his poor soul and almost never lets his mind run over the past. If the thought of making any effort to be better crosses his mind at all, he believes that once he has confessed his sins, he ought to be perfectly happy at peace. So I have experienced this, no? Yeah. Once maka-confess ko, wala ko mortal sin, safe na ko. Pero dili na mao ang perfect charity, no? So we have to always think of eternity. We have to always think of heaven. We have to always think of the passion of Christ, no? So we have to always think to be better, to acquire virtue, to be better, ang atong patience, to become better, ang atong charity, ang atong generosity, no? Ang atong gentleness, to become better and better and better. Not just to enter heaven. He assists at Holy Mass very much as he would at any ordinary activity. Muralag ordinary affair. He does not think at all seriously of what he is doing and finds no trouble in chatting about all sorts of things while on the way there. Guilty. Paingon sa simbahan, mga topic, it's not about God, lahi-lahi, no? Dari ko na igo sa what he's doing and finds no trouble in chatting about all sorts of things while on the way to the Holy Mass. Possibly he will not give a single thought to the fact that he is about to participate in the greatest of all the gifts that God, all-powerful as he is, could give us. So really an eye-opener ning write up ni St. John Vianney, no? He is about to participate in the greatest of all the gifts that God, all-powerful he is, could give us. Frequently, he will even present himself before the presence of God without having any idea of what he is going to ask him in the Mass, ha? He has few scruples in cutting out the prayers before Mass. Napagiday dapat prayer before Mass. He has few scruples in cutting out the prayers before Mass. During the course of the service, he does not want to go to sleep. Kasi gusto matulog, pero, of course, and he is even afraid that someone might see him. But he does not do himself any violence. Ang iyahang struggle to stay awake is not that much. Makatulog siya, sorry Lord. No? He does not want, of course, to have distractions during prayer or during the Holy Mass, yet he only put up some little fight against them. Fast days, when it comes to fasting, fast days are reduced to practically nothing. Kaduha raman ta sa isa katuig mo required mo fast, no? Ash Wednesday and Good Friday. And then sometimes we are being so legalistic pag yun, no? You know, a lukewarm person by advancing the time. Ah, pwede na kumukaon kaya kuanan eh, no? In advance of the main meal or making the collation so abundant that amounts to a full meal. So, sa ganay rule sa fasting, one full meal lang yun. And then, ang duha ka meal, dapat kung imong itotal ang duha ka meal, dili mo equivalent sa usa ka full meal. Oh, so uban, dayaon pagit nila ang ilahang fasting which amounts to a full meal. Plus mag-advance pagit ang time, no? If they ever observe the fasting. When he performs good works or actions, his intention are often mixed. Sometimes it is to please someone, sometimes it is out of compassion, and sometimes it is just to please the world. With such people, everything that is not a really serious sin is good enough. So we become legalistic, no? For a lukewarm person, basta dili lang serious sin, ego na. For a person that really loves God, who is burning for God, will not settle for less. Manang isulti nga, the good is the enemy of the best. We have to always strive higher if we really, truly say that we love God. Di ta mo contento nga to stagnate in that level. Because if you be contented in that level lang, you really do not love God. No? A person who loves wants to grow higher and higher and higher every day. They like doing good, being faithful, but they wish that it not cost them anything, or at least that cost very little. So gusto sila mohimog maayo, pero kung mahimo, it will cost them little lang. Emotionally, financially, physically, no? They would like to visit the sick, but it would be more convenient, they wish, if the sick would come to them. So ikaw na lang bisita, no? They have something to give away in alms. Makahatag sila, they're willing to give, they're generous. They know quite well that a certain person has need of help. Ako igo ko ane, no? But they wait until she comes to us, and instead of anticipating her, yeah. Matag man ko ba, pero mo siya nang ayo. Di wala lang po. Ready na unta ko. Mampun na yatong kinaiya usahay ba? Willing na unta ko, pero taas man siya pride. Wala man siya nang ayo. Di po ko. Pero mo na example ni ko, ana, St. John Vianney. They know quite well that a certain person has a need of help, pero wa data kabalo ang tao na ulaw lang yun na ikog. Na may mga tao mga ikogon. So, sometimes magod mo assume ta nga ang mga tao kasagaran bagagnaong. Pero daghang tao po di ay nga maikogon, no? Dilita ng tao bagagnaong. But they wait until she comes to us instead of anticipating her, which would make the kindness so much more meritorious. Sa kanang kitay mo anticipate kinang wapatagi ng ipangayuan ihatag na ta, mas dako di ay og merit. Mas dako merit. We will even say, my brethren, that the person who leads a lukewarm life does not fail to do plenty of good works. Yeah. Pwede siyang daghan siyang good works, no? They frequent the sacraments to assist regularly at all church services. But in all of this, one sees only a weak, languishing faith, hope which the slightest trial will upset, a love of God and of neighbor which is without warmth or pleasure. Everything that such a person does is not entirely lost, but is very nearly so. Hapit na gyud. Dili pa lost, but hapit na gyud malos. Kulba. See, before God, my brethren, on what side are you? On the side of the just souls who seek but God alone? Or are you of the number of these slack, tepid, and indifferent souls, such as we have just been depicting for you? Down which road are you traveling? So, who can dare assure himself that he is neither a great sinner nor a tepid soul, that he is one of the elect? Wala magin nakabalo na to, no? So we always ask ourselves, wala magin nakabalo. Alas, my brethren, how many seem to be a good Christian in the eyes of the world? Sa mata sa tao, good Christian sila. Who are really lukewarm or tepid souls in the eyes of God? Who only knows our innermost heart. God knows. In the eyes of the people, yeah, pwede tamo mailad. Tanawan ko ninyo. Pwede. For God, no? But God knows if we are tepid or burning for God. Let us ask God with all our hearts if we are in this state to give us the grace. So if we are in this state, mangyod, kuntinood mangyod, to give us the grace to get out of it so that we may take the route that all the saints have taken and arrive at the happiness that they are enjoying. No? Now, pakita na ko ninyo ang Chaplet of the Divine Mercy. Ang katapusan nga novena is the ninth day, di ba? Look at what Jesus said to Saint Faustina. Today, on the ninth day, no? Bring to me souls who have become lukewarm and immerse them in the abyss of my mercy. These souls wound my heart most painfully. Tiaw mo na, na ay sanctifying grace, pero maopanikali ang mga diay ng mga souls nga nag-wound sa heart ni Jesus most painfully. My soul suffered the most dreaded loathing in the Garden of Olives because of lukewarm souls. Mas grabe pa di ay kumpara itong mga tao nga mga grabe ka mga kasasala. Mas gisakitan siya because it is already indifferent. Eh, no? They were the reason I cried out, Father, take this cup away from me. Dito siya mas nahadlok. No? Ini nananghid na gusto sa iyang amahan nga, kuhaan na lang ni kumahimo. No? If it will be your will. For them, for the lukewarm soul, the last hope of salvation is to run to my mercy. Wow. So, eye-opener. Kulba ang being lukewarm. No? For them, the last hope of salvation is to run to my mercy. Saint Vincent prayer, na ay sa mga readings na ako, akong gi-include rin, ni Saint Vincent Ferrer on how only a few among thousands were saved. Because sometimes, morning ginahimo sa devil sa tuwa, ginapakampante bitaw ta, you're good, you're okay. We always compare ourselves to other people who are corrupt, criminals, no? And then, sometimes we pat ourselves in the back, you're okay, you're okay. But, look at what as the writings of Saint Vincent de Ferrer. He relates that an archdeacon, na usa ka archdeacon sa Lyons, he gave up his position and then he retreated to a desert place to do penance, no? And then this archdeacon died, no, sometime. Namatay ning archdeacon dungan kay Saint Bernard, same day, same hour. Namatay siya with Saint Bernard. Wala gisulti kinsa ngalan ning archdeacon. After his death, nagpakita siya sa iyang bishop. And he said to his bishop, Monsignor, that at the very hour I passed away, 33,000 people also died. In the whole world, maybe, no? Out of this number, Saint Bernard and myself went up to heaven without delay. Three went to purgatory, and all the others fell into hell. Imagine, out of the 33,000 who died, me and myself went to heaven, three went to purgatory, and others fell into hell. Next, one of our brothers, well known for his doctrine, kauban nila ni Saint Vincent Ferrer, maay kaya mo preach his holiness and his well known for his doctrine. He preached the ugliness of sin, of impurity, unsa kadautan ang sin of impurity. So forceful nga pagka-preach that a woman fell dead of sorrow in front of everyone. Siguro promiscuous siguro ning bayhana, no? And then na-struck it siguro siya sa message. She fell dead of sorrow in front of everyone. And then she came back to life. Tigaan siguro siya grace sa Ginoo, no? She came back to life. And then iyang gi-recount kung unsa iyang experience sa iyang near death experience. No? She said, "When I was presented before the tribunal of God, 60,000 people arrived at the same time from all parts of the world. Out of the 60,000, three were saved by passing purgatory and all the rest were damned." Imagine, 60,000. So, unsay sulti ni St. John Chrysostom about how many will be saved? sa ingon ni St. John Chrysostom, "What I am about to tell you is very terrible. Yet I will not conceal it from you. Out of this thickly populated city, with its thousands of inhabitants, not 100 people will be saved. I even doubt whether there will be as many as that." See, still, St. John Chrysostom, "I do not speak rashly, but as I feel and I think and think, I do not think that many priests are saved, but that those who perish are far more numerous." Even sa mga priest, no? Gamay lang maluwas. Makita man nato karon on how serious they are, on how some, a lot of priests are not so serious about their vocation, no? Saint Justin Martyr, "The majority of men shall not see God, except those who live justly, purified by righteousness, and by every other virtue." So, Saint Louis de Montfort, "The number of the elect, or the saved, no, is so small that were we to know how small it is, we would faint away with grief. One here and there, scattered up and down the world." So, it is an eye-opener, mga brothers and sisters, no? Lukewarm soul. Hello, Brother Brian. Si Sarah. Boy, sis Jeannie. Hello, Frances.
Hello. Good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Brother Glenn. Good evening. Ang mga wala na pa nag-greet. Okay.
Oy.
China man yung greet mo ng China man yung luyo nila ni ko ano?
Osaka na din.
Ha?
Osaka.
Ah, Osaka. Pwede rin ay no? Japan. Sige. Osaka. So, eye-opener sa ato, ano?
Eye-opener, Jud.
Okay. Wala si MacRae ron? Wala si MacRae?
Wala siya.
Sige. So, closing prayer ta, sis?
Sige. Okay. Ang putang Hail Mary. May the Father, the Son, and the Spirit.
Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Bye bye Frances.
Bye bye Frances.